I'm joined now by Creighton Athletic Director Marcus Blossom. Marcus, thank you so much for taking the time to join me. How are you today?
Great. Thanks for having me, Matt.
Now, Marcus, you're in your fourth year as Creighton Athletic Director. So what are you most proud of?
Well, I'm most proud that our teams have had some amazing success over the past 3 years. Our coaches have done a good job putting our teams in position to achieve some really special things over the 3 years I've been here, and looking forward to year number four.
It's the million-dollar question that everyone's asking, but what do you think of the big picture of where we're at right now in college athletics? Seems like there's a different answer every day, almost.
You know, I look at it as a positive. I think anytime you are embarking on a period of change, you have to look at it and embrace it. I think it's an opportunity for student athletes to be able to benefit off of what they bring to the table in a variety of ways. So it's a great time to be a student athlete. It's a great time to be at Creighton. I think you have to be at a special place in order for you to feel comfortable and confident that your organization or your athletic department can survive in this this tumultuous, I should say, period of change. And we're in a good spot, so I'm looking forward to it.
What are some of the positives that you're hearing from your student athletes?
Well, obviously, they can benefit off their name, image, and likeness, and they haven't been able to do that, you know, if you look 4 years prior. So that's a good thing, you know. Many student athletes, you know, because they spend so much time competing and going to the classroom, obviously they don't have the time they would like to have in order to make money and to do some things that the general student may be able to do. So I think that's a positive, you know, for the student athletes as a whole.
How does Creighton position itself in this landscape, particularly as a non-football school?
Well, we have to do what we do and do it better. We have to continue to raise revenue, pack out the arenas, men's basketball, women's basketball, volleyball, manage our operation as best as we possibly can, continue to engage our supporters, whether it's donors, fans, trustees, I feel if we have everyone on the same page, all aligned to achieve the ultimate goal or to achieve the same goal, I think we'll be in a good place.
Let's talk Big East. UConn was in discussions of leaving the conference to head to the Big 12. What do you think about the future of the conference?
Strong. Best basketball conference in the country. Feel very good about the future direction of the Big East. UConn, you know, with having 1A football or FBS football, they have to explore those opportunities. It wasn't a surprise, but I think they value the Big East from a basketball perspective. So we march on.
How do you think Creighton is performing right now from an NIL perspective?
You know, we're performing well in some sports and can do better in others. You know, this is a change for all of the college programs, and we're adjusting as time passes. So we can always do better. I'm happy with our men's basketball collective. Our volleyball collective has done very well over the past couple years. And we can improve on with some of our other teams. So we're looking forward to doing that.
How do you marry that, some of the big sports that have a lot of the eyeballs, men's basketball, volleyball, with some of the sports that you mentioned need some work?
Well, you take it one day at a time. You approach people that may have an interest in a particular sport, inform them on how they could help. And student athletes, they can be ambassadors too. This is for the student athletes. And if they're ambassadors for themselves, as much as we are ambassadors for them, they'll be in a good spot.
The Bird Club, talking about that men's basketball mm-hmm. collective, launched yep. Project 11 yep. this past May. Sounds like it was pretty successful. What can you offer on that, and what's that going to help?
You know, I can't offer any details, specific details, but, you know, it generated, you know, a fair amount of dollars to help go towards our men's basketball program. So we'll continue to do initiatives like that as we are in this interim period where all of those dollars go externally to collectives or directly to student athletes.
Talking now about the women's basketball program, head coach Jim Flannery met with reporters last week. He yeah. mentioned going into the transfer portal, there were a couple D1 players that right. were out of the budget. Mm-hmm. So going to take a look at a sound right now, if we can take right. a listen.
Honestly, we shot for some Division I transfers and we couldn't touch them. The going rate is you know what I don't know what it is, but we couldn't touch some of the transfers that we thought we could get. It was a little eye opening that players you thought, like, we didn't think we were shooting for the moon. We thought we were shooting for somewhere between here and the moon, and we weren't getting a lot of love.
So, Marcus, what do you think of those comments?
There's never enough. So there's always going to be players that want more than what a particular institution or collective can provide. Kudos to Flan. He's done an amazing job with the resources he's been given. And one of my priorities has been to support women's basketball at an even higher level to give them more resources than they've ever had before. So they've done a great job with what they have, and I'm confident if we give them more, they can be even more successful.
And they do have two D2 transfers coming in. He mentioned it worked out pretty well for Ryan Hawkins, so he's excited.
Yes, it did.
Creighton men's basketball tipping off the season on November 6th. What are your expectations for the team?
Well, you know, a Coach Mack's team is always going to do very well. He's going to get the most out of that team, the most out of the players. So I expect us to have a good year. A couple new faces on the roster, as you know. So it may take some time for everyone to gel, but I think we'll be right there in the hunt for the Big East title.
And you mentioned that's one of the goals. You want these teams, especially men's and women's basketball, right, to be competing for Big East regular season titles.
That's the goal. We have two great coaches that can put us in position year in and year out to do that. We're able to recruit some very talented student athletes, whether directly as freshmen or as transfers. So we're confident that we're going to be pretty successful this season.
And fans don't have to wait until November 6th to watch the team in action. There's a big event coming up later this month, and it's going to support a good cause.
Yeah, we wanted to do whatever we could to provide tornado relief. And this is an opportunity for us to give back to the community, hosting Purdue in an exhibition game where the dollars go to charity. We expect a good crowd on October 26th. And as I just mentioned, most importantly, we're able to provide a healthy amount of resources to our community.
Not a typical exhibition opponent. That was 20 minutes away from an Elite Eight matchup last year.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if the team is the same, but it's a great program. They're always in the hunt for Big Ten championships. They compete for an opportunity to go to Elite Eights and Final Fours on a yearly basis. So it's a great opportunity to host a program like Purdue.
You talked coaches that are great, that help elevate this athletic program. Greg McDermott received a contract extension back in March. How did those discussions play out?
Well, we say, Greg, how long do you want to coach? And he wants to coach a little bit longer, so we try to give him the resources that it takes to keep him here. So all healthy discussions. We're glad that he's here for the foreseeable future.
What does he do for this athletic department, for this university?
Well, he does a lot. You know, he puts a great program, a great team on the court every year. He's great in the community. He helps build the brand of Creighton nationally. So he's been great for Creighton over the last 14 years.
And he wasn't the only coach to receive a contract extension. How important is it that Jim Flannery, Kirsten Bernthal Booth also received the extensions that they did?
Very important. For one, it's important that they want to be here. So they want to be at Creighton. We want them here. They do exceptionally well with our programs, and we think they're going to do even better in the future.
I wanted to ask about the status of the new baseball softball facility. Where are we at right now with those discussions?
Well, I can comment on softball. As you can see, if you're driving near DJ Sokol Arena, we started the construction for softball. So looking forward to that facility, and that's scheduled to be at least the field component of it. Is scheduled to be done by the end of May 2025. The baseball piece, I'm not at liberty to discuss the exact details of that, probably for another couple weeks.
Okay. Mark Kingston, you got a coach in waiting that's going to be joining Ed Service for his final season this year. Why was he the right guy for the job?
Well, Mark's won at a variety of places and a variety of levels, and he was really looking forward to getting back to the Midwest. He spent quite a bit of time at Illinois State, where he had some success. He also has some experience at a private institution like Creighton during his time at Tulane, and also at Miami in Florida. So he felt this was a great opportunity. He has a track record of success. He may have a little chip on his shoulder as well, so we thought Mark would be a great fit at Creighton. And Coach Service thought he'd be great too. I've consulted with Coach Service before making that hire, and he thought it'd be a slam dunk.
And Mark said that all the wins this year will be counted towards his resume. Well, Ed will take the losses.
Right. That was the deal.
Right. So we'll keep an eye on that. Well, with the work you've done here at Creighton, some people might say that you'd be a great fit for an athletic director mm-hmm. role at a Power Four school, and that you may be ready to take that jump at some mm-hmm. point. What do you say to those people?
Man, I'm happy at Creighton. We still have tons of work to do. We're building facilities. We're trying to take the next step in our athletic department. We have several programs where I think are on the precipice of doing even greater things. So my eyes are in Omaha.
You talk softball with that new facility too. 30-win season for that program, and mm-hmm. can imagine the facility is only going to help with recruiting. And
yeah, Chris has done a great job in a short time with that program. And we're not expecting it to necessarily go up 30 to 35 to 40, but she's going to do well over her time here. And, you know, I think she could take us to a Big East championship.
That's the goal, right?
That's the goal.
What's the next project you want to take on?
Well, we have some facility projects that, you know, we'll announce in the near future related to sports performance and nutrition for our student athletes. So first and foremost, baseball and softball. And after that's done, we'll take on the next thing.
Great. Marcus, anything that I didn't touch on that you'd like to add before we wrap up here?
Creighton's in a great place. I mentioned our great coaches and student athletes. We also have a great staff, you know, that works. You know, much of our staff, you see them on a game-by-game basis when you're around covering games. They do a phenomenal job. They work extremely hard. So I want to give staff kudos as well.
Great. Marcus, thank you so much for your time. Appreciate you joining me today.
Appreciate it.